Howdy. I hope your quarantine is going great because mine is... I'm going to answer some questions, eat some nachos. Let's start getting into some of the serious tour questions. All right, first question. How many times a day do you brush your teeth? You know, nowadays, I'm up to like 3-4 times a day, which is great. I'm always brushing my teeth on the road. I'm lucky if I'm able to do it once a day. And that's a fact. So don't get too close to me. Ashley is Trashly. If you could recommend one camera for beginners, what would it be? Literally any camera you can get your hands on. Just get to work and start doing it. Austin Rowe Memes asks, can you in any way describe your creative process while putting together the tour docs? One, I would like to say thanks for having a meme account of me. I feel like I don't really deserve that, but I appreciate it. Come here, Daisy. That's okay. I don't have a concrete set plan on how I put together the tour doc episodes for any band that I work with. It's mainly just me filming as much as I can every day for a week straight on the road. And then once I feel like I have some sort of narrative or story that I could tell, I start to craft the first episode over the next day and a half or 2 days off that I have. And then I start all the way over for the second episode. I mainly just wing it. Chili Magpie asks, was the European crowd different to the US, for example, New York's to Glasgow's? I'm going to assume that you're talking about AJR, and yes, the crowds are extremely different. How do you use different platforms to promote yourself? I really don't know the formula behind social media. You can eat your nachos. It's my microphone won't pick it up. Like, how do you spin your camera without dropping it? Like when you spiral it. I use a glide cam. I face the weights horizontally with the camera instead of it being vertical, which is, I think, how you're naturally supposed to build a glide cam. When I spin it, the weights go in a 360 motion, which allows me to get that spiral. If you took a picture of us at a concert and posted it, is there any way I could get it? If you see yourself on my Instagram story and I took a photo of you at a concert, if you want to screenshot the post on my story and it's of you, obviously you can do that, but I am not going to send out a photo of you because I get way too many messages from you guys asking of that, so I'm sorry. Days of Sam asks me, how do you keep a level of consistency through your work so that it's recognizable? I honestly, I will let you know when I figure that out because that's a... Oh, you can only see your butt? Show some of your favorite shots from Neo Theater. Dumpy Pug, how would I go about getting into your line of work? I feel like I'm going to have to make a video really detailing my experience and how I was able to fully get into this line of work. To give you a brief answer now, it's just a matter of putting out as much work as you can. Spam the world with your best work. Don't spam it with mediocre work. Spam it with your best work. Quality over quantity. Always. Darian Clark, talk and discuss your go-to equipment, audio, visual, etc. I have a whole video dedicated to what I bring on tour. I'm going to put that in the description. It answers that whole question right there. What is your Hogwarts house? My Hogwarts house is... Slytherin. That's right. How high is your step count after a concert? How high is my step count after a concert? At least 50 steps. What age did you get your first camera? I was... My first real camera I bought for myself when I was 16, and it was a Canon Rebel T3i. And I used that sucker all the way until I graduated college. When making a video, do you pick the music you use before or after? That's a really solid question. It's kind of both. There's a set of songs that I listen to on a daily, weekly, and a monthly basis. I'll always think how I can use that in some sort of video and put visual to it. So sometimes when I'm editing the episode itself, these episodes will take me into a direction where I thought I wasn't able to take it into, in which case I might change my mind. We got a nacho. It's so good. It's like the best day of my life right now. How did you know that being a photographer is what your life held for you? Was it scary? It wasn't scary. I definitely was always a filmmaker first. I knew that when I wanted to get into the touring world that I needed to be able to take photos as well as shooting video. The photography world, it was mainly something that I was just like, oh, I have to learn how to do this. So I'm just going to start doing it. Again, yeah, I really didn't know photography would take me all over the world, which it has. And I'm very grateful for that. But I don't think that's all that life holds for me is just photography. I mean, there's so many other things that I want to do. As a tour photographer, how do you ensure you don't produce redundant content? Dude, these questions are so good. Like, They're so good. They're so hard. I really just try my best every night when I go into a show, especially for this past Lumineers tour. I try to go into every single show not shooting the same angle with the same lens and the same camera. I really try to force myself to go in different directions for each song throughout the set, so that way I could catch a moment that I wouldn't normally catch every night. And honestly, that worked for me pretty well. You know, there was a lot of times I was able to capture a lot of special moments in the audience, a lot of special moments on stage that I didn't know I could catch, and that was because I was forcing myself to do something different every single night, which led to non-redundant content throughout the tour. What are some of your favorite photographers and videographers? Brad Heaton, who I've admired his work for such a long time. Mark Eshelman as well, with his episodical tour docs that he's done with 21 Pilots. Andy DeLuca for sure is up there, along with Sarah Eastman, Hannah Edelman, Deanie Chin, Christian Sarkeen, Bridget Craig, Chris Blocked. I love his work, and he's a really good friend of mine. Pete Souza is a god amongst gods. He's an absolute legend, and I love his photography so much. And I was very lucky to be able to meet with him and hang out with him during this past Lumineers run, and he's such a great guy. I really wish I could do do a video with Pete and like interview him or whatever. That would be insane. What's your favorite car seat headrest song? I'm gonna say Bodies is my favorite car seat headrest song. Do you keep in contact with artists you've shot for in the past? Yeah, absolutely. A lot of them have turned out to be some of my very close and best friends. I think that's something that's really special about this world, and being able to tour constantly with some of these artists that you grow so close with them and you end up becoming some of their best friends. And man, I'm really lucky I've been able to live this life that I've lived so far. That's such a great question. I don't know. I think that's all. Yeah, I don't know. I feel really good about all of those answers. You guys see this? Look at this. Look at this dog. That's all I got. That's the soup. Okay, that's all I got.